Well, hello, Minnesota high school football fans. Welcome to Prep Preview on YouTube.
Yes.
I'm Randy Schaefer, along with the overly excited Craig Norkus. Here we go. As we dive into another season of Minnesota high school football coverage, we are excited to be back.
Excited?
I know you are.
That's not even the word. But, you know, we haven't been on this playing field, on this set, since November 9th of last year. So it's kind of like, are we feeling a little bit of the rust, you know, kind of like the preseason type thing?
I don't know about you.
Well, I got to admit, okay, I'm a little bit nervous and scared that you're going to be a little rusty and commit some verbal turnovers. So I'm prepared.
I'm sure you are.
Yeah, I'm going to actually call an audible right off the top of the show to assist you.
Oh.
Okay, are you ready?
This ought to be good.
Okay, pay attention. I right, 65 toss power trap, blue sky left, 42 WP rocket, nail black razor X, gel, jello, Jack East, jumping Jessica West, yo yo U4, out the door, Tesla speed limit ignore, line lone limb, stone, pristine Christine, north nod, P code, SIE dirty, state fair, Firefox, mayonnaise, Omaha 8, spread sprocket, space mace, mulligan. On two, ready, break.
I have no idea what that means.
Did you not get that?
No.
The crowd noise?
No, we don't. We don't need.
Okay. Well, let's just do it again. Right?
No, 65. No.
Okay. Well, how about we just remember the last line? Spread sprocket, space mace, mulligan.
Okay.
Mulligan being
mulligan.
Out of all that, the word that you need to remember, just like your golf game where you use a lot of them. In this show, I'm going to give you a lot of mulligans for your verbal turnovers.
I'm also very good at a foot wedge during golf. Matches as well.
Okay, well, you know, I don't make the same mistake twice. I make it six or seven times just to make sure.
Right.
Let's get on with the show.
Let's do that, shall we? Coming up, I'm going to reveal my annual preseason All-Metro football team. This after conversations that I've had over the last couple of weeks with virtually every head football coach in the Metro. That's coming up in a minute. But first, football teams hit the field across the state on August 14th. We are off and running.
You ready?
Yep.
So hit. Here. Get up. That's it, Ben. That's it. Good. Love it. Nice job. There we go. Hey, you don't move, you get spiked.
Football practice opened up around the state on Monday, August 14th.
That hit.
And at Holy Family Catholic.
Good. Nice feet. Good.
It's a whole new look with Dan O'Brien taking over as head coach.
Good. Hey, I like that, Luke. I like that. Grind it. Good.
OB left a successful job at St. Thomas Academy to take over at Holy Family.
I don't know that you ever made a mistake, Nelly, have you?
Coaching along with legends Dave Nelson and Jeff Ferguson.
Oh, that's awesome. What do you got right here?
Jump to left blue 47.
Let's see if we can do that.
Those Hall of Fame coaches with over 450 wins, 10 state championships between them.
That's it.
OB also added defensive guru Jeff Maritko.
Boom, boom, right inside there. There you go. Hey, now come with it, right? Come with it.
Who worked with Fergie at Totino Grace.
Nice job, y'all. We're going to defensive stuff. We're going to be in our same spots.
It's a star-studded coaching lineup tasked with getting Holy Family's program back up to speed. The Fire has lost 21 straight football games dating back to 2020.
Here we go. Fire on three. One, two, three.
Fire!
Get to work. Let's go.
Let's go, DBs.
This is an overhaul.
DBs.
But Dan says it's been a lot of fun so far, and he was surprised by the number of players who showed up on Monday.
DBs right over here.
Inside linebackers.
Though, and Coach Mo. Big old Coach Mo. Here we go. We're excited. We got 62 kids showed up on our first day today, and hopefully we'll be able to sneak a couple more. And that's where it all starts. You know, you have to have numbers in order to practice. And I think when you start to rebuild a program, and that's where we're at, you know, we haven't won a game in 2.5 years. Kids aren't really excited to come out until they kind of test us a little bit as a coaching staff. So we were pleased. Our number was, as I said, 62 today, and we're pleased with that for a start.
Well, that's Holy Family. Of course, every other school across the state has opened up their football practices as well. This is a little bit closer look at Holy Family's schedule, just bits and pieces of it. They're going to open against Academy Force at home. They're going to play 3A-powered Dassel Cokato on week two. They're going to close out against SMB in October. It's a schedule that's very challenging for Dan and his all-star coaches, but also there's some opportunities, I think, there for them to maybe surprise some people.
Well, this creates a real talker, I think. It's one of the great stories of the season when you take a program that hasn't won a game in 2.5 years.
Right.
You put three literally legendary coaches on that staff, arguably a fourth really good
with
coach.
With Maricko, yeah.
And, you know, what is the
and
ceiling?
Including Dan as well.
Right. Yeah. So what can they do? Can they win one game? Can they win five?
Right.
I'm really looking forward to see what happens with this and talking about it down the road.
This is what we call the buy-in. Can they get the kids to buy in? And I think from what we saw, because we were there on the first day of practice, it looks like there's a lot of
energy. There's some buzz going on
there. There's some
buzz. So, again, we'll be back to this.
Yeah. Very good. All right. Well, we had a unique opportunity to check in with some of the Metro's best football players in early August. We gathered 10 of the Metro's best at Breck High School for our annual Prep Sports Extra TV promo shoot. A lot of fun. Gives us the opportunity to talk with these players, get to know them a little bit, right?
Yeah, and what I remember that day, I mean, it was great. It's always great to get the players together and start thinking about the season. But I remember it was 95 and quite humid, and I remember I had a soaked, sweaty, swelling,
yes,
saturated shirt literally cauterized to my body.
Yes.
But other than that, that was a great day.
Yes, it was. We're going to show you the actual TV promo for the show in just a minute. But first, hear from Gopher recruit Sam Macy of Chanhassen on his amazing summer. Sam Macy, number 9, was a force on the football field last season for Chanhassen. The junior defensive end made some big-time plays, but after the season, he didn't earn the scholarship offer he desired from the Gophers. Simply, Sam needed to show the Gophers he could put on weight but maintain his athleticism.
Went from 195 to 220, put on quality weight, quit basketball so I could put on weight and get ready for this football season. Put me on a weight program, eating, lifting, and then speed. So, I mean, I brought my 40 time from 4.77, 4.6 flat. When you put on 25 pounds to do that, it helps. You come to our camp, you work hard, you earn it, you know, you'll get your offer.
Ben, there you go, Ben.
That's exactly what happened June 4th, I think it was. They offered me, I committed on the spot. It was crazy. It was almost, when I went into PJ's office, I was almost just blackout because I was too scared to talk to him. Because, I mean, he's kind of, I love PJ. He's an intimidating guy. So he's got a lot of energy. So, yeah, it was good.
Sam is now committed to the Gophers, and the sky is the limit. It's yet another example of how hard work and determination can pay off. Pretty cool about seeing him jump over that bar.
Yeah.
I don't know if I could limbo underneath that bar, let alone jump over it.
Well, you know, we always talk about the life lessons made from football, and here's just another great example.
Right.
Like, you want something, go get it.
Well, they put the carrot out there and said, hey, you know what, we literally love you as a player, but we need to see this, and he proved
it. He went out and did it. You know, one of the great, I talked to Sam at that promo shoot, and the quote that stuck out to me the most was, I get to play with guys that I've played with my whole life. It's pure bliss, really.
Yeah.
That was his quote.
Right.
So he's calling it pure bliss. So, and then you can kind of see how that translates into the way he's working out
and
so
we'll
hard.
And we'll be talking a lot about that Chanhassen football team as we roll along.
Yes, we
certainly
will.
For opening
foreshadowing.
Day, too. Yeah. My thanks to those players for stepping out of their comfort zone to say some lines as part of the Prep Sports Extra promo for this season. This is year 40. Of the PSE. More on that later. Here's the promo if you haven't seen it. It's football season, and this is a milestone year for the Prep Sports Extra.
40 years of prep football in Care 11.
40 years of coverage.
Amazing.
All the best highlights.
All the crazy plays.
All the heart-stopping action.
Plus, you get all the scores.
And we can't wait for you to watch.
This is year 40 of the Prep Sports Extra. Don't miss a moment. It's going to be the best season yet.
Watch the Prep Sports Extra football nights at 10:15 on Care 11. Sponsored by True Stone Financial.
I loved how animated those guys were. We told them to have fun with it, and they certainly
did. And that was an awesome promo. Shout out to Michael Sherman, Chris Parr, and Dan Crow. They did an outstanding job with that.
Yeah. So thanks to those guys. All right. There are so many great storylines heading into the prep football season, which kicks off on Thursday night, August 31st. One of them for me is just how healthy Minnesota high school football looks and feels right now, post-COVID and concussion worries. Numbers are up. Kids are getting recruited hard by all sorts of top football college programs, and the fans are about to be treated to a high-caliber safe game. Is football healthy in Minnesota?
I think so, yeah. I mean, I love how it is in Minnesota, and my friends in Georgia probably get mad at me. I think we do it right here. It's still education-based. And it's important, but it is not the end-all be-all.
I think it's growing. I really believe that. And I think that if you asked any football coach right now, right, the game has changed. I think we've changed the way we teach tackling. I think that's a huge thing right now.
Convincing parents that it's a safe sport. I get that one all the time. Big kids, you see them walking around and you should be out playing football and, you know, well, my mom won't let me or my dad won't let me. I hear that one a lot. And so it's trying to convince even families that football's safe and it's a safe sport, safer today than it's ever been.
Is football healthy in Minnesota right now?
I think it is. I really do. I think we've weathered the storm of concussions. We've weathered the storm of COVID. And I think we're getting numbers that are, it seems like we're talking to a lot of people around, maybe the last 10 years, numbers have dipped a little bit, but I think they're on the rebound.
I feel good about it because I look at guys that I know that do the same thing I do, and they're awesome people, right? And the numbers are there. Everyone says, the kids are changing, right? They're not what they used to. No, they're not. I mean, they're all kids, right?
Yeah.
Our world's a little different. We didn't have the cell phone. We didn't have all the media stuff, but the kids are the same.
Is the game of football healthy in Minnesota, do you think?
I think it is. I think Minnesota is quietly turning out a lot of athletes. And I say quietly because everyone talks about down south, down south, down south. But we put a lot of kids in football, basketball, softball. You know, I can't speak on the baseball because there's so many levels of baseball. But, you know, I was just looking at the softball team and there's a whole bunch of girls going to play. And I think it's awesome. So I think it's healthy. I think we have ball players. And yes, I think it's a good place to be.
And Marcus Harris should know about coming out of the state to go from high school football at Brooklyn Center to play at Wyoming, right, one of the nation's top receivers during his time in college.
And when we talk about the sport being healthy in Minnesota, yep, I think it's important to talk more about the safety of the game,
yep,
and specifically the emphasis on safer tackling. According to the general tackling definition, it is a dispossess of an opponent of the ball or to stop the player from gaining ground towards the goal or to stop them from carrying out what they intended to do.
Right.
In the old tackling process, the head was essentially used as an extra limb.
Yeah, we were talking.
But in the last decade, new tackling techniques featuring a leverage-based shoulder tackling system with a major emphasis on taking the head out of it, essentially the head behind the ball
carrier.
So
instead of me coming in front of you to try to make that tackle, they're teaching them now to come this way.
And
we used to say at that time, that's an arm tackle. We don't want an arm tackle.
Right.
That's what's changed the most.
That's the change. And in many cases, defenders not only find this technique safer, but they can actually make sounder, more fundamentally successful tackles with more control. And in fact, the Seattle Seahawks were the first NFL team to officially employ this technique in their teaching, and their data shows tackles were made with a higher percentage of successfulness tackles were concluded at a higher rate compared to the older, unsafer way of tackling.
Now, some would argue if you watch the NFL, you don't see a lot of that still. You see a lot of, obviously, the contact.
Well, the game is, the speed of the game.
The speed of the game is a lot faster,
a little
too
different, but.
But high school for sure, and here's the key, Craig. The key is not only teaching it in high school, but teaching it down at the youth level too. That's where it all starts. And if the youth coaches teach it the right way, then when those kids get to be at high school,
it's a foundation.
It's a foundation.
Right.
Yep.
Okay.
Very important part of making the game safer here in Minnesota for sure.
And keeping it healthy.
Yep. All right. Here we go. We're going to meet now the Care 11 preseason All-Metro football team for 2023. Again, I've talked to virtually every Metro head football coach to set up this team. We're going to list all the players for you. We're going to start with the quarterback position on offense. And I'm going to list two. Tanner Zelnowski, three-year starter out of East Ridge, real student of the game. And Milo Spasovic from Minnetonka. Now, Mark Esch, who's the coach at Tonka, used to be the coach at Mankato West when they had all those great teams and quarterbacks. He tells me that Milos is, he thinks, the best quarterback that he has coached.
And Zelnowski with Eastridge, they won after kind of having an average start to the year. They won four in a row heading into the Class 6A state quarterfinal against Maple Grove, which they only lost by seven, and Maple Grove was the eventual state champ. So that says a lot about Zelnowski. And with Mark Esch saying that about this quarterback, yeah, and he's led Mankato to two state titles and six state semifinals,
right,
that's really saying a lot.
It really is. Now, Zelnowski isn't a big guy. He's only about 6'1", 185. He's the ranked number one quarterback in Minnesota by Prep Red Zone. Threw for 2,900 yards last season, 27 touchdowns, the most in Class 6A. Strong arm, smart leader. You'll hear from Tanner throughout the fall. I had a chance to talk to him, and you'll hear from him down the road. But he will be the leader of a dynamic offense for Eastridge. I named three preseason running backs. Maxwell Woods out of Chanhassen is 5'11", 180, committed to North Dakota State. Savion Hart's going to be the workhorse for St. Thomas Academy, 6'1", 190, very experienced. And Logan Bunker is a 1,000-yard rusher off that defending state 5A champion team from Elk River.
Let's get back into Woods.
Yeah. You like this guy, don't you?
Well, yeah. I covered three Chanhassen games last year, and he is a tremendous runner with great speed, agility, and elusiveness. He's 5'11", 185. And head coach Cullen Nelson says he will play defense and be dynamic on that side of the
Which
ball.
Which is scary, right?
Yes. Well, you know, it is scary. But what I liked about, well, first of all, he says he worked on finding an extra gear, but if you look at this run, I mean,
what extra gears are there?
But what really fascinated about what he said what he worked on over the summer,
yeah,
he said, "I got lots of rest." That shows maturity beyond years to me, because you don't hear high school students thinking of rest as being important. But when you're going into a full season,
yeah,
and your body is going to be ready for all the load and the impact it's going to take.
Especially playing both sides of the ball.
Both sides of the ball. And his nickname by teammates is Max, but he admitted, "My mom says, no, you're not Max, your name is Maxwell." That's what he told me.
There you go. Well, I asked Maxwell back in early August to describe himself. What makes him good?
I believe my ability to make people miss on the football field is one that is, I think it's a very special ability of mine, probably my best. And then I feel like when I get in open space, I can run past someone, make a move on them. Even on the defensive end, I feel like I do a very good job in pass coverage. I've worked on it a lot.
And he's going to be one to watch for sure. We named three receivers to the preseason All-Metro team. Kaijon Cummings-Coleman out of Coon Rapids, considered the top receiver in the state. Tyler Nystrom from Moundsview. His dad is a former Gopher great kicker, Dan Nystrom. He'll lead the Mustang offense. And Meyer Sweeney's a junior out of Edina, getting a lot of D1 attention. 6'4", 215. He's already been offered by Miami and Iowa State.
And you talk about an overall athlete. Cummings-Coleman has 8 school records combined in football, basketball, and track.
He's an outstanding athlete. He's a great kid, too. And I had a chance to talk with Kaijon and his coach earlier this summer.
As a player, you know, my skill set is not, I'm not going to say more advanced than other players, but like my ability to be able to catch the ball and, you know, be explosive after that and like take a play that should be 5 yards and what, turn it into a 25, 30 yard gain. You know, I think that's what I describe myself as, is like just an explosive player, no matter where I am with the ball, getting the ball, no matter what.
Tell me a little bit about Kaijon and what makes him special.
He can do it all on the field. This is going to year number 11 as a football coach. I'd never been around someone as athletic as him. He can run any route. He can make anyone miss on the field. He's got great hands. And I think the thing about him that sometimes get lost with skill positions or wide receivers, he's tough.
I do expect that come into the season to be maybe bracketed a little bit, taken out of games. But, you know, I got faith in me and I have faith in my team no matter what, because my team's going, we expect that to come. So we're going to work on getting the ball to everybody else, because that's the only way a team can work.
And they do have some skill players on that offense coming back for Coon Rapids.
Kaijon's nickname is Butter Pecan, he said.
Butter Pecan.
Yes, he said that comes from his family, so
okay.
Not sure what that's all about.
All right.
You wanted to mention that.
All right. I appreciate that. Preseason All-Metro athletes. Simon Seidel out of Hill Murray, going to the Gophers on scholarship. Quentin Cobb Butler out of Woodbury. Talk about two players that are electric. These two guys for sure.
Yeah, and Simon Seidel is a younger brother to Sawyer Seidel, who was our All-Metro for running back for us last year. Now, he shows amazing maturity to me because he told us he actually deleted his Twitter account so he could stay focused on football this year. That shows wisdom beyond years. And his nickname is Abiga, which is adopted from his name in Congo.
He, of course, committed to the Gophers. Then he shut down the recruiting process at that point because he was so excited about playing for PJ. Here's our offensive line. Emerson Mandel's headed to the Gophers on scholarship, 6'5", 300. Aiden Harrell, 6'4", 330. Prior Lake just continues to turn out amazing linemen. Will Sathers, a three-year starter for Mike Grant at Eden Prairie. He's an Ivy League kid. Kane Anene out of Eastridge is headed to Kansas on scholarship, 6'6", 275. And Wyatt Bell, 6'2", 290, headed to North Dakota on scholarship, part of a great Rogers football team.
Now, what is the over-under on the number of pancakes that are going to come from that group of five guys right there?
Talk about sitting down to breakfast.
I put it at 100 because if each of those five guys averages two pancakes a game, that's 10 if you project 10 games in the season. So over-under 100, you taking the over?
Yeah, I'm taking the over.
Okay.
Yeah, easily those guys. they are really, really good offensive linemen. We'll keep an eye out for them. All right, let's check out our preseason All-Metro defense. And we're going to start with the number one player in the state, Wyatt Gilmore out of Rogers. He's number 41, defensive end, outside linebacker, 6'5", 265. He's going to Oklahoma on scholarship. The guy's got a motor. He's big, he's strong, he's smart. A lot of players, or a lot of coaches, rather, talked about him in my conversations.
He told us there's nothing better than sacking a quarterback. He told us he goes for the ball every time while sacking a quarterback. That not everyone does that.
That's true.
That's advanced teaching. He describes being an edge rusher as playing chess with the strategy involved with it as setting up his moves. And Wyatt Gilmore has a nickname of Happy Gilmore. And if I say Happy Gilmore is a better golf comedy than Caddyshack, I could potentially win a preposterous statement tournament.
Well, here's what Wyatt had to say to me about his offseason and getting himself better.
Definitely my pass rushing, just because in Minnesota we don't really pass that much, and it's something going to the SEC, I gotta get good at, for sure. I've been working on my get off a lot, and a good first step, that's one of the biggest things, and just knowing the moves and just perfecting them and just active hands and strong hands.
So here's the preseason defensive line. Wyatt Gilmore out of Rogers, Jade Abasiri out of Prior Lake, Max Mulgeson out of Two Rivers is heading to UNLV. By the way, Abasiri going to the Gophers. Trent Page of SMB is 6'4", 255. He's going to Yale. And then there's a junior, Abu Tarawali out of Providence Academy, 6'3", 275. He's being recruited by a number of Power 5 college football programs. To me, Craig, this position is the deepest recruited position right now in Minnesota.
Well, Mogulson said he doesn't like snow, which is ironic with the name Mogul, but he's going to UNLV, so I guess he'll avoid the snow. And he thinks Minnesota
high school. That was a stretch.
he thinks Minnesota high school football is super underrated.
Yeah.
Jade was the most physical specimen of the bunch to me, and he said, I just like to hit people,
which
language on our show, that is actually perfectly acceptable.
Exactly.
And then one more, his nickname, Jade's nickname by his teammates was Cocoa Butter, but his nickname by his coaches is the Nigerian Nightmare.
Yeah.
It's a couple of polar opposites.
He's going to be a guy to watch. He is, and Craig is right, he's a physical specimen.
Trent Page they call Batman, by the way.
Yeah, Trent Page, very smart kid heading to Yale. The linebackers. Now, Sam Macy could probably be a defensive end. So could Menard. They're interchangeable. We put him at linebacker for purposes of preseason. Sam, of course, going to the Gophers. You've already heard from him. Mark Rendell. Rendell is 6'3", 230. He's going to provide that experience for Forest Lake on the defense. Langdon College has really kind of You know, he's morphed, okay? He started as a slender free safety for Armstrong. He's kind of built himself up, and now he's a linebacker slash defensive end. He's committed to NDSU. And Antonio Menard of Lakeville North is going to Air Force. He's a great kid, smart. He's going to play some outside linebacker and defensive end for Brian Vossen.
Well, Menard told us he worked on his footwork as a priority, and he recalled his first play ever as a sophomore. He literally fell down.
Right.
So he's made an emphasis on working on his footwork. And you know the question, you know what he likes best about the Prep Sports Extra?
No.
Quote, seeing the honesty. Whatever that means is, I guess okay. We're pretty honest with our work.
I guess
so
we'll try to be that.
Seeing the honesty is what he likes the best.
Well, check out this guy. We're honestly going to tell you, this kid, Tyler Smith of Chanhassen, there's a reason why he leads the All-Metro defensive backs. We both love his game. He's a dominant player late in the season last year for the Storm. He hits like a Mack truck. Smart, always seems to make the big play when Chan needs it. Tyler's also a great hockey player, but man, this kid can really play football.
Yeah, all these highlights you're seeing are from a game I covered against Waconia last year, and he literally went off, as you can see. It was one of the most dominant single-game performances on the defensive side of the ball that I saw all year.
All right, let's check out the rest of the defensive backs. Zayshon Rich is a fabulous two-way player from Minneapolis North. Will Washington is heading to NDSU, three-year starter out of Apple Valley. He turned 17 in September, so he's just a really young guy at 6'1", 195. Will Quick, three-year starter for Mike Diggins at Centennial, and Tate McDonald led the state in interceptions with 8 last year for Waconia. Pretty solid defensive back group. And then our choice for kicker punter is the Eastridge junior, Luke Ryersey, who has a big leg and had a strong sophomore year for the Raptors.
And he's the younger brother of Grant Ryersey, who actually made an All-Metro team for us and actually went on to play for the Gophers.
Yeah, absolutely. So that's the list of the preseason All-Metro team. You can find this full list on our website at care11.com. All right, I want to dive into one of these storylines here.
There's something fascinating going on
in 5A.
Yeah,
so in the offseason, the coaches and athletic directors in Class 5A football decided we want to make a change. And to me, this is awesome. ADs like Will Wackman at Spring Lake Park worked on new schedules that first helped some 5A teams get relief for two difficult schedules, but also worked with the really good football teams who wanted to play better competition in the regular season. All 5A coaches were polled. They were surveyed in the offseason. Who do you want to play? Who don't you want to play? And the result was a restructuring of 5A, more of a section schedule in a lot of ways, but good teams playing good teams and not so good teams playing not so good in order to help them build their programs back.
This is great.
It led to the North Star District. So 43 of 44 5A teams are in one district. Here's an example. The North Star South Gold. It features Mankato East, Mankato West in the same sub-district as Chaska, Chan, and Waconia. They're also section opponents, so there won't be any discussion, rather, during the section seating meeting, because they will have all played each other, so they can really base that their seedings off of actual head-to-head play. But what this does is it leads to extremely fun matchups in the regular season. Here's an example. Mankato West is now coming to the Metro, or Metro coming to them in the regular season. Week 2, they're at Andover. Well, that never would have happened before.
Never.
They're hosting Chaska in the regular season. They're at Chan September 29th. Circle that game, everybody.
This is like a playoff bracket here.
And they're hosting Rogers on the last night of the regular season. Just an example of what 5A has done to help their schedules and help the fans actually, I think, enjoy the 5A experience. I had a chance to talk to a few coaches about it.
Everywhere I go, from the barbershop to the grad party, people want to know about the schedule, and I think it's great. People on our schedule got to play us too, so we're excited to go out and see how we stack up, get in the playoffs, and then we'll sort it out from there. But I think anytime you can pair up quality programs against quality programs that are up and running. I think that's a really positive thing.
I mean, as soon as our schedule came out, I mean, our kids immediately looked at it, and what jumped out at them was week 8, we have Mankato West, which has just been a fantastic game the last 2 years in the state semifinals. And we've never played them in the regular season, and we've only played them the 2 times in the state tournament, but it caught the kids' attention right away, and to the point where we go, okay, that's week 8. There's a look at a lot of the other stuff.
You can't look past the start of the season, but a lot of those players in 5A looked at their schedule and went, oh my gosh, look at this, look at this, look at this.
That's the only con to it, if there is one, is like you've got players looking at week 8 and the coaches are like, okay, let's hold on, let's do one at a time now, and we'll get to that.
And you and I looked at the schedule, and I'm not going to have any surprise here, but Elk River hosting Chan in week 1, Thursday night, the 31st.
Our first.
They've never met before, and it's our spotlight game.
Our first spotlight game of the year.
Elk River is going to be a product of this. 5A champ, and Chan is so loaded with talent. It's going to be, they expect over 5,000 people.
5,000 to 7,000 people, I think, will be at that game. Yeah. And I will be running around that field like a little kid.
And I will be there too. It's going to be fabulous. All right. Well, this is year 40 of the Prep Sports Extra. We started this football show back in September of 1984. Here we are. Craig's been part of the process now for 22 years.
22 years. Yeah. And speaking of running around like a little kid on the field, that's one of the things that I love, because I get to kind of vicariously live through these players, and I'm running around with my GoPros and pregame with the players, and obviously I've lost a step. I figured that
or
out.
Two,
but that's part of what I love, is it just brings me back to my youth on Friday nights. What we're going to see here shortly, one of the amusing things to me is when you watch the Prep Sports Extra and how seamless and how professional it is. Actually, behind the scenes is actually a lot of chaos, isn't there?
It can be. There's no doubt. We always tell each other we love each other before the season starts, because sometimes it gets a little...
That love dissipates.
Yeah. I've been gathering some thoughts from coaches, past and present, on what the impact of the Prep Sports Extra has been over the last 40 years. Here's a few thoughts.
Becker won.
14-7, Becker
won. First quarter. 7-0.
Let's go!
There is a... In my view.
15, quick smile for the Prep Sports Extra.
There's something about football in Minnesota that becomes a fabric of our lives. Wherever, any corner of this state, anywhere.
Yes, call pretty. To you.
Set hike.
1 minute.
After the ball games, after you put the kids away.
Watch this catch.
People would gather to watch the Randy Shaver Prep Sports Extra.
Get ready for some great plays.
Are we good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Impact, immeasurable.
Well, how about this? Matamidi tonight. Nice touchdown pass. Redding, it was tipped.
From northern Minnesota, from Baudette to Caledonia and everything in between.
No.
Everybody has made it personal. It's a personal thing.
Miss Randy.
That people really buy into. It's not just a quick highlight.
Miss Randy.
It's a name and an identity.
Rogers, 42-14.
And the community loves it, the kids love it, and the coaches love it.
Got a quarterback draw.
Set hike!
Thank you.
4 minutes.
Well, I think it's one of the things that every kid that's played high school football over the last 40 years remembers.
Friday night is not a Friday night with Prep Sports Extra.
Gravel.
Okay. How do they not get right back to the ball?
No, that's not them.
No,
Gravel.
I'm telling you, it's him.
Write it. Handwrite it. Give it to me right now.
Everyone runs home. They go to the safe parties. First thing they're doing, they're flipping to it. You know, they want to see your face. They want to see the highlights.
That was great. That was awesome.
And then?
That was right in my grill.
Michael Floyd from Springer.
That'll make the Prep show tonight.
It gives kids who are putting their hearts and souls in tons of hours.
Did you get him blocked?
A crushing ISO block.
And creating families through football. It gives them an experience where they kind of feel big time.
Ryan Schmeling.
7-6 Roseville.
Yee-hoo! Opening night is here.
And they kind of have a moment where they feel like that pro guy. And they feel like that college guy.
We'll see you next Friday night for another edition of the Prep Sports Extra. Good night. Just like riding a bike. Just like riding a bike.
They never get that again. That's awesome.
Great job, you guys.
Yep.
And so we kick off year number 40 on Thursday night, August 31st. We'll be back on Friday, September 1st. And we'll be here every football night throughout the regular season.
So that video of me in that piece was from 2007. That was 16 years ago.
Yeah, let's take a look.
But I'm not sure what the heck I was doing with my
what
hair back
then. What in the world?
Then.
It looks like a bird's nest.
I don't, well, is there something it's related to? Can you, maybe,
oh,
does that
come
look
on.
Like, does that
Mahomes? Now that's a stretch.
Is that, that's a stretch?
That's a stretch.
Well, our arms are similar, aren't they?
Oh my gosh, no they are not.
Okay, well still, I don't know what I was thinking back then.
I don't know what you were thinking either.
Speaking of hair.
Yeah.
You know, so, In honor of...
Oh, my God.
Of,
it's the 70s.
Yeah, this is actually 1986. In honor of our athletes in training,
okay.
all the work they're putting in this summer and now in camps, the conditioning, all the getting their bodies ready.
Well, you have a Walkman in
yes,
your hand.
So in 1986, yeah. This is what I used to okay. do my conditioning while running.
Okay.
And I'll raise the question to our audience, how many of you are familiar with the Sony Walkman?
This show is completely off the rails right
Back
now.
In 1986, there were no AirPods, there were no iPods, right. There were no cell phones, there was no internet. So if you wanted to listen to music while on a training run, you needed a Walkman. I would literally carry this thing around while running. Now you see how it says sports on there? The sports version of the Walkman was extra rugged, ultra splash proof. It was the Cadillac of Walkmans. It even had a radio tuner. And you used to play the cassette tapes on it with your music.
God.
And if you look closely at that cassette tape, it says high flux density oxide formula. What the heck is that? Nobody knows, but it's probably the Cadillac of cassette tapes as well. I wonder if that picture is from 1986 too.
Oh my goodness.
Man, maybe not.
Oh man. Right down memory road.
Oh, you know
way
what?
Too fast.
The headband's from 1986, too. Here,
yes, it smells
it.
Like it. Yes, thank you. Appreciate it. All right, are you done? That's
Not
it.
Not quite.
We're done. That's our first prep preview show of the season. We're going to be back on Wednesday, August 30th, with a complete preview of Week 1 football. We'll reveal our spotlight games. You already know it's Elk River
yep.
Cham, but we'll tell you about our Friday spotlight game at that point, too. Wednesday, August 30th, right here on YouTube.
And we will see you for the Week 1 show on August 30th. And in parting, just remember, when people tell you that you're going to regret something in the morning, just sleep in until noon and bypass the morning altogether.
Once again.
All we do is solve problems on this show.
Yes, we do. Or we create some, too, as well. Thanks for watching. Again, my preseason All-Metro football team is on care11.com. High school football's here.
It's back.
We look forward to a great season. We'll see you August 30th. Does it still work?
Yeah, it does, actually.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does. It still works.